All right, let's go ahead and get started. Good afternoon and welcome, everyone. My name is Tara Davis, and I am the Director of Staff Wellbeing and Engagement at APA. I'll be your MC this evening. Before we begin, I want to remind you all that this is being recorded, and we will share the link to the recording with everyone after the ceremony. And now let's welcome APA President, Dr. Sandy Shulman.
Thank you very much, Tara. Good afternoon, and thank you so much for joining us. It's a great honor for the APA president to be able to present such well-deserved awards to some of our most distinguished psychologists every year, typically at the APA convention. Although the pandemic has kept us from being together, I'm really pleased that we have been able to find a creative way to continue this tradition, albeit virtually, this year. This afternoon, we will be honoring our colleagues who have been at the forefront of advancing psychological science and practice and promoting our discipline to a broader audience. You will notice that in the chat box on the right side of the screen, there's an opportunity there for you to put in your congratulations to the awardees throughout the ceremony. And this obviously will be captured as part of what we are recording. We'll also be sharing some links to more information about the awards and the awardees, and encouraging our awardees to engage as well. When you're not on camera, you might be talking with folks. And now I'd like to let you know that joining me today are Dr. Arthur Evans, APA's CEO, and APA Deputy CEO, Dr. Jim Diaz-Granados. So please welcome Dr. Evans and Dr. Diaz-Granados. Arthur, would you like to say a few words?
Sure. Thank you, Sandy. Well, first of all, I want to welcome everyone as well and to really congratulate all of the awardees. You all are the best of our field. You pursue excellence, and because of that, you're being recognized today. So I want to personally congratulate you and thank you for the work that you do. This year has really shown how important our field is. I can tell you there have been so many times when we've pulled from the research that many of you have done, the work that you've done, your expertise, to really be a resource to the nation. And if there was ever a time when our field was needed, it is now. And so I'm just very grateful to all of you who have dedicated your lives to excellence. Congratulate you again on the work that you have done, and look forward to working with you and applying the work that you've done to our field. Thank you.
Jim, do you want to say a few words?
Thank you, Sandy. I will echo everything that Arthur has said as Deputy CEO, as well as the Acting Chief Science Officer. It's just a real honor to see everyone on this screen in this Zoom rather than a room, but just really appreciate everyone for all of your work, your dedication throughout your careers, and just know that we have made an impact as a discipline and profession, and continue to want to do so and increase that ability to do so. And you all have really raised the bar very high. We want to thank you for that.
Yes, thank you so much. As I said to the awardees before we went on air today, when I look at the credentials and the accomplishments of this group, it makes me wonder what I have been doing with my life. They are just all so accomplished and so dedicated and so remarkably accomplished. So, Tara, I think it's time to get started.
Sounds great. Thank you, Dr. Shulman. First, we'll present the International Humanitarian Award, which recognizes extraordinary humanitarian services and activism by psychologists, including professional and volunteer work conducted primarily in the field with underserved populations. Now, I'm going to ask Dr. Shulman to present these two international awards, first being the International Humanitarian Award, since one of her primary areas of focus has been on international issues in psychology. Dr. Shulman?
Thank you. I'm delighted to present international awards this year. This is such vital work. First off, the recipient of the 2020 International Humanitarian Award is Dr. Niels Peter Reigard. Dr. Reigard co-founded the Fair Start Foundation, which is a global organization working to create local systems of quality childcare for abandoned, refugee, and separated children. Fair Start has trained more than 450 instructors from partner organizations, strengthened government's national care competencies, and assisted over 30,000 children in 26 countries. Dr. Rygaard, congratulations, and we'd like to give you a few moments to make some comments. Thank you so much. And unmute yourself, sir.
Well, I'm Nils from Denmark, and the whole thing is due to the help from so many researchers and professionals around the world, because I just had this idea when I was going home from Chile looking at orphanages, and everybody said, yeah. So they said, yes, we can. Today's count from the UN is 140 million orphan children in the streets, in foster families, in orphanages, and refugee camps. And what I've seen is underprivileged and uneducated caregivers around the world. I mean, last year I was in Tijuana. I entered a room, 21 abandoned babies, newborn, and two caregivers around the clock. In my opinion, the ability to care for these kids will decide whether our planet will have democracy or chaos. Because look at them when they grow up. That's why I had this idea to make an international network of researchers who graciously contributed, joined with the NGOs, and now we're up to 40,000 children, and we work for Greenland government, educate their staff in Inuit versions, and we work for SOS Children's Villages in four East African countries, where we trained the foster families of 5,000 children now. And this outcome is produced by four staff and a volunteer board. So in my experience, online learning is our bridge to improve mental health by large-scale interventions, also under the impression of Corona. So all I have to say is that if you go to fairstartfoundation.com, you can find free training programs in attachment-based care and learning in 20 language versions. So having the goal of UN partnerships around the world, that's also our mission. Well, our next stop, I hope, will be Latin America, because I have a big network there and a lot of people need it because of the migrant situation. So I just want to thank thousands of people, in fact, who contribute to Fair Start every day, professionals. In particular, Bob McCall and Chris Grock from Pittsburgh University Office of Child Development. They supported me all the way. So did Telmo Mourinho, the former president of our European Association. So to my family, to APA, the Psychology Coalition of NGOs at the UN, I'm saying, let's help children save the world. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you, Dr. Rygaard. It's such an extraordinary honor to be on the same Zoom screen with you. Thank you so very, very much. And thank you also for staying up late in Norway so that we could honor you in this way.
So well, I'm in Denmark, so.
Sorry, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you and congratulations. All right, our next award is the Award for Distinguished Contributions to the International Advancement of Psychology, which recognizes distinguished and enduring lifetime contributions to international cooperation and the advancement of knowledge in psychology. Dr. Shulman, I'd like to ask you to present this award.
Yes, the recipient of the Award for Distinguished Contributions to the International Advancement of Psychology is Dr. Sharon Horn, a colleague of mine in counseling psychology. Dr. Horn partners with colleagues in Russia, Kyrgyzstan, Colombia, South Africa, the Philippines, and other countries to investigate critical social issues, including violence against women, LGBTQ justice and mental health, and culture-centered training in counseling psychology. She leads the profession in the decolonization of international psychological research, especially by amplifying the voices and wisdom of colleagues outside of the United States. Such vital work. Dr. Horn, would you like to say a few words, and my sincerest congratulations.
Thank you very much, Sandy. Thank you very much for this honor. It's very special to receive this award alongside so many of my esteemed colleagues, many of whom I consider dear friends. And I'd really especially like to thank APA's Committee on International Relations in Psychology, which continues to do phenomenal work in fostering international engagements and connections among psychologists all over the world. This award is really has to be shared with so many of my nominators and colleagues who I work alongside in a quest for liberation and social justice for LGBTQI people, namely Catherine Norsworthy, Linda Russell, Sherry Rostowski, and Julie Cook in the U.S., Jean Nell in South Africa, Yelena Kim, Yelena Kosterina, Olga Yarova, Yelena Sergeyevna Molchanova, Nina Bagdasarova in Kyrgyzstan, and Ala Shabaltas, Alexander Varaksa, Maria Sabanayeva, and Olga Razmakova in Russia, and Raynell Alexander Shaparo, Maria Luisa Ramirez, Maria Elvia Domingos Blanco in Colombia, and Bea Torres and Eric Manolestis in the Philippines, as well as many colleagues who I can't thank because they live in countries where it would be unsafe to name them. So we have a lot of progress made, just a lot happening in the last few days with great strides for LGBT justice in Bolivia and Romania and other places, but there's still a lot to be done. And I'd like to extend my gratitude for my many colleagues in ICINET, the International Psychology Network for LGBTI issues, including Clinton Anderson and Ron Schlittler, as well as many others in that special community of LGBTI psychologists from organizations in every region of the world and who worked with me to create the ICINET statement and commitment for LGBTI issues, which has now been endorsed by more than 40 national and international psychology organizations and is available in 13 languages. I'd really like to thank my wonderful colleagues and students in counseling and school psychology at the University of Massachusetts Boston for their unwavering support. And finally, I have some extra special psychologists to thank. My parents, Andy Horn and Gail Horn, who modeled for me the many compelling ways one can be a psychologist and a human being, and my super supportive psychologist spouse, Heidi Levitt, who breaks new conceptual ground on a regular basis. And finally, my kids, Eden and Joshua, teach me more about how people should care for one another in surprising and meaningful ways each and every day. So thank you so much for this honor, and it's genuinely shared with many, many supporters and allies around the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Sharon.
Congratulations, Dr. Horn. And I love what you shared about being a psychologist and a human being. So congratulations to both of our international award winners, Dr. Horn and Dr. Rygaard. Next, we have Education and Training Award. This award recognizes the efforts of a psychologist that has made distinguished contributions to education and training, produced imaginative innovations, or has been involved in developmental phases of programs in education and training in psychology. So the award for distinguished career contributions to education and training in psychology is presented to Dr. Stephen McCutcheon. Dr. McCutcheon is recognized for his national impact on education and training through his leadership in the Association of Psychology Postdoctoral and Internship Centers, the Council of Chairs of Training Councils, the APA Commission on Accreditation, and VA Psychology Training Council. Still, his greatest accomplishment will always be the positive influence he has had on the lives of hundreds of trainees over the course of his career. Dr. McCutcheon could not be with us today, but we congratulate him on this achievement. Also in the area of education is the 2020 APA Sci-Chi Edwin B. Newman Graduate Research Award, given for the best paper published or presented by a graduate student during the previous calendar year. This year's recipient of the 2020 Sci-Chi Edwin Newman Award is Dr. Andrew Young Choi. Dr. Choi authored an outstanding research paper, Syndemic Behavioral Risk and Suicidality Among Bisexual Adolescents, a Latent Class Analysis, which examined the syndemic theory of health disparities among bisexual adolescents using national data to model patterns of co-occurrence across sexual risk, substance use, and victimization. This paper, co-authored by Drs. Tania Israel and Karen Nyland Gibson, was the basis for his selection as the recipient of this research award. Dr. Choi?
Hi, it's great to be here. Thank you so much for having me and the ceremony. And, you know, I first want to thank the work of APA and PsyChi and this year's award committee. There was a lot going on this year. And, you know, I should say that I feel really undeserving of this award as an individual. But having said that, I'm really honored to accept this award on behalf of the larger community of folks that supported me and this project to come to fruition and all of our collective intellectual contributions that made it possible. I'm also really honored to join the ranks of the much more eminent scholars who are previous recipients of this award. And it only fuels me to continue my scholarship, you know, where I hope to, you know, foster the kind of transformative and radical change to dismantle racism, homophobia, and other kinds of state repression, especially for the communities that I serve, which are sexual minority people of color, Asian Americans, and other underrepresented BIPOC and intersectional populations. Now, there are so many people to thank than the time that I have and to whom I should dedicate this award, but I want to highlight several of my colleagues and friends and family. Where applicable, I am going to repeat the prefix doctor in the light of the recent op-ed, which if you know, you know. So I'm going to, you know, ask for your understanding in the repetition. So of course, Dr. Tania Israel, my dissertation chair, Dr. Karen Nyland Gibson, my lead methodological trainer and also dissertation co-advisor, the APA Minority Fellowship Program and all of my APA MFP family, the Bisexual Research Collaborative on Health, Dr. Jennifer Borden, Dr. Thandika Brown, Dr. Will Hua, Dr. Bryce Jacobson, Al Jamora, Dr. Brian Tehyuk Kim, Dr. Timothy Kim, Dr. Jessica Liu, Dr. Sabrina Liu, Dr. Hotaka Maeda, Dr. Stephanie Mendez, Dr. David Yuen, Mona Shahrabani, Dr. Shruti Swami, Dr. Ana Romero Morales, Dr. Allison Tanoye and the Counseling and Student Development Center at the University of Hawaii, Manoa, where I am currently affiliated, and Dr. Oscar Vidalis. Of course, I want to thank my parents, Drs. Eunyoung Choi and Yeong Son Choi, and my ancestors who survived decades of colonization and state violence and nevertheless focused on their legacy of fighting for cultural preservation and revitalization. And very finally, I want to thank my various communities here in the country and also abroad who are in struggle for justice and that which inspire me and hold me accountable for continuing to good work. Thank you.
And on behalf of all of APA and all doctorates everywhere, thank you, Dr. Choi.
All right, congratulations to our education awardees. Next, we'll recognize the recipients of our science awards. The Board of Scientific Affairs Committee on Scientific Awards has selected three individuals who have made notable theoretical and empirical contributions to basic research in psychology to receive the Distinguished Scientific Contributions Award. First, we recognize Drs. Lynn Nadel and Drs. John O'Keefe. Drs. Nadel and O'Keefe were awarded jointly this year for collaborating to develop a framework linking the discovery of neurons that encode spatial location with a computational theory, resulting in a foundational advance in the field of cognitive neuroscience. Dr. O'Keefe could not join us this evening, but we'll hear from Dr. Nadel. Dr. Nadel?
Yes, I had to unmute first. Well, let me start by thanking the awards committee for this honor. While one doesn't become a scientist for the accolades, they're nonetheless much appreciated. And having said that, I need to immediately make clear what's obvious, that this award honors not just me and John, but also those whose collaboration over the years made our work possible. On my part, I must mention my parents, without whose encouragement I would certainly not have gotten very far. And not just them, but my two brothers and two sisters who delighted in my progress and tolerated my otherness. And not just them, but also my five children, Melissa, Ken, Misha, Layla, and Yael, whose own progress through life has put the wind in my sails on many occasions, and who put up with the peripatetic academic career you honor today. And finally, my wife of 30 plus years, Dr. Mary Peterson. There really aren't enough words to express how central she has been to everything I've accomplished in these years, both personally and professionally. I've been very lucky in my academic life in more ways than I can relate in 2 minutes, give or take. Lucky to be at McGill, where I interacted with giants in the field from the outset, including Peter Milner, Brenda Milner, Dalbir Bindra, and Don Hebb, and where I met two individuals whose paths have intertwined with mine to the present day, the already mentioned John O'Keefe and Morris Moscovich. John apologizes for not being able to join us today, and he wanted to make sure that I emphasized how much we are both students of Hebb, and in our work on the cognitive map, have been fulfilling his project of grounding and explaining psychological concepts and processes in terms of brain activity. This may seem obvious, but we suspect it is not. Hebb's project was clear to those of us fortunate enough to learn from him, but it took many decades before the field caught up. I was also lucky to have done a postdoc in Czechoslovakia in the late 1960s, during the euphoria of the Prague Spring and then the crushing sadness of the Russian invasion, with two extraordinary people, Jan Boresh and Olga Borishova, who taught me as much about life as about science. My years working closely with John O'Keefe were magical, and I'm really happy to be sharing this award with him. My collaboration with Morris Moscovich over the past 20 plus years has been rewarding beyond measure, as has our friendship. There are many other colleagues to thank, among them Jeff Wilner, Jake Jacobs, Carol Barnes, and Bruce McNaughton, all of whom I met while spending 2 years at Dalhousie University in Nova Scotia in the late 1970s. Lee Ryan, Jamie Edgen, Rebecca Gomez are just some of the colleagues I've worked closely with in my 35 plus years at the University of Arizona. Students and postdocs who have graced my lab made enormous contributions to my work. In the interest of time, I can just single out Jess Payne, Veronique Bobot, Oliver Hart, Almut Hupback, and Kate Simon, but there were many others. So, in the end, thank you to all of those who have made this day possible. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nadel.
All right, next we recognize Dr. Stephen Hinshaw, recipient of the Distinguished Scientific Contributions Award for seminal contributions to understanding and treating attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, ADHD, and overcoming the stigma of mental illness. Dr. Hinshaw.
I'm unmuted and I'm thrilled to receive this award thanks to everyone at APA, including the awards committee. I've worked all my life to advance basic and applied science, to teach and mentor, to advocate, and to produce narrative accounts as well. I'm still overwhelmed at how much remains to be done in clinical and developmental science, but recognition like this is still greatly appreciated. My work is focused on developmental psychopathology, the study of transactional, nonlinear processes that shape typical and atypical behavior across the lifespan. I've used case control studies, experiments, randomized controlled trials, experiments of nature, and prospective longitudinal research. I've also taken some dives into policy related to how educational practices might influence the diagnosis and treatment of kids with neurodevelopmental disorders. I've also, over time, more fully recognized the roots of my interest in psychology, namely our family's experiences of severe mental illness, in particular for my father, whose lifelong bipolar disorder was both misdiagnosed and professionally silenced when my sister and I were young. It took years of shame, terror, inspiration, and then gradual opening up for me to begin to bear witness to our experiences and to investigate how stigma might be reduced, especially in adolescents and young people. And for our family to remain silent no longer. My memoir, Another Kind of Madness, has been a culmination. Among the many paths to stigma reduction, humanization is crucial, especially during this current year of pandemic, heightened awareness of racism, and fractionation, rather than the integration we all so desperately need. There's just no way to list the many mentors, colleagues, students, and my current lab members with whom I've had such unbelievable connections over the years. UC Berkeley and UC San Francisco are my homes away from home. I dedicate this award to the memory of my mother and father, Virgil and Aline Henshaw, to my sister Sally, so active in holistic medical education in her career, my late cousin Matt Schoonover and his brave parents, Ellen and Paul, and to my beloved wife, Dr. Kelly Campbell, and our sons, Jeff, John, and Evan. But I just want to remind everybody, I'm not done. I dedicate myself to renewed research, advocacy, narrative, collaborations, and mentoring. And with respect to mentoring, indeed, the best students and trainees must enter our field with boldness, energy, and vision if psychology is to advance toward rigorous science, evidence-based care, and the furthering of human rights. From the bottom of my heart, thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Henshaw. We look forward to your continuing and amazing contributions to psychology. Thank you so very much. Congratulations.
All right, the next recipient of the Distinguished Scientific Contributions Award is Dr. Alyssa Newport. Dr. Newport is recognized for her seminal contributions to our understanding of the role of early experience in acquiring the stable use of linguistic rules. Her multiple influential lines of research include the innovative less is more theory about superior learning in children compared with adults. Dr. Newport.
Thank you so much for this award. I really appreciate it. I wanted to thank the APA and the committee and colleagues who nominated me for this award, and also especially my students and collaborators on my research. Most especially my mentor and dear friend, Lila Gleitman, and my long-term collaborators, Richard Aslan, my long-term collaborator and my husband, Ted Sapala, my long-term subjects and children, Susanna and Zach Sapala, who have been the kids I got to watch growing up and learning language from beginning to end. My very close Georgetown collaborators on the recent research that I've been doing, Alex Dromarek, Peter Turkeltub, Barbara Landau, William Gaillard, and Anna Greenwald. I'd also like to say some personal and very special thank yous, because the last few years have been really terrible, but also inspiring in many ways for watching people's personal courage. For me especially, I've watched friends and collaborators standing up for others. And I have friends who have inspired me and kept my spirits up when I couldn't believe what was happening around me in the world. At a personal level, my colleague Richard Aslan and my seven other co-defendants and our amazing lawyers, Anne Oliverius and Jeff McAllister, with whom I stood up for our graduate students against sexual harassment by a faculty member at the University of Rochester. And on the bigger world stage, amazing people who are too numerous to name, like Anthony Fauci and Joe Biden, who spoke out for others, the scientists who developed the vaccines that we hope are going to save us all. While my research is on language and the brain, I do want to say to psychologists that I hope we'll all, that those of you who study social psychology, which I don't work on, will somehow return us to hoping we can finally understand empathy, how we can understand what it is that makes some people do the right thing and care about others while other people are selfish and care only about themselves. And maybe we can figure out as psychologists how to develop vaccines that turn us all into people who care about others, all of us. Maybe we can figure out how as psychologists we can develop some vaccines that will change us all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Newport, and thank you for your language to live by. And we really appreciate that very, very much.
Our next award is a Distinguished Scientific Award for the Application of Psychology, which is presented to a person who has made distinguished theoretical or empirical advances leading to the understanding or amelioration of important practical problems. I'd like to ask Dr. Shulman to present this award.
Yes, this year's recipient has exhibited such strong passion and persistence, all in the name of the application of psychological science. And he is also a dear colleague of mine. Dr. Stephen Holland is being recognized for outstanding research on the treatment of depression, including the analysis of mechanisms and moderators of therapeutic change, and for promoting the dissemination and implementation of evidence-based treatments across different countries and cultures. I am proud to honor my colleague, Dr. Steve Holland. Would you like to say a few words?
Sandy, you're too kind. Thank you very much for that lovely introduction. Thank you, APA. This is a great honor, and nothing could be more meaningful to me. Former colleagues here at Vanderbilt, Ken Dodge and Ann Kring, great colleagues, and I miss you very much, and I wish you all the best where you're at, and it's great to see you here with this. Depression is an eminently treatable disorder. It's the most prevalent of the major psychiatric disorders, but eminently treatable. You can treat it with psychotherapy, you can treat it with medications. The nice thing about the psychotherapy, psychological interventions, they have long-term enduring effects. You can actually learn how not to be depressed. My father was a clinical psychologist, absolutely marvelous. My mother was very much involved in politics, both high school dropouts that had a great love of learning. And I very much appreciate the fact that they never pushed me to do well in school. They always pushed me or encouraged me to follow my interests. And that's what I've done basically throughout my career. And I could not be happier about that. I've had my own personal experiences with depression at least three times in my 20s. I could have fit in any one of my own projects. And since I've been doing the work with cognitive therapy, I just can't do that anymore. I just could not sustain a depression anymore. And I think, you know, our evidence is suggestive of the notion that you can learn how to deal with things in ways that you no longer get depressed. My wife, absolutely marvelous Judy Garber, is a developmental psychopathologist, has done some of the best work in prevention, and has shown me that while I may be able to treat depression, she can prevent it in the first place, and I have great regard for that. Rob DeRubis is my longtime friend and colleague. Virtually everything I've ever done of any worth I've done in collaboration with him, although his best stuff he's done without me, I'm not sure exactly how to interpret that, but absolutely marvelous as well, and we've been working together for over 40 years. Terry Wilson, when I was a young faculty, I used to tell my graduate students, someday I want to grow up to be Terry Wilson. And I never quite got there, but I think he's the person that nominated me for this, and I have great fondness and affection for Terry. In recent years, new colleagues, Vikram Patel, psychiatrist, very much involved in global mental health, has got me doing things in rural India. Just been a great delight. Paul Andrews, the evolutionary biologist, has got me to rethink everything I ever thought or believed about depression. I've now come around thinking of it as an evolved adaptation. And what we really want to do is find out how best to facilitate what it evolved to serve. But the person I want to thank most of all was Tim Bett, the best mentor ever. Best decision that I ever made, along with Judy, was heading off to Philadelphia, Judy, to work with Marty Seligman, me to work with Tim Beck. And at 98, he is still going strong and is an absolute marvel. So Tim Beck, all the best to you.
And thank you so much, Dr. Holland. Congratulations.
Congratulations. All right, the next seven Distinguished Scientific Awards are for early career contributions to psychology. The Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contribution to Psychology in Cognition and Human Learning is awarded to Dr. Timothy Brady. Dr. Brady's work relies on creative psychophysics experimentation and advanced computational modeling of learning to reveal the fidelity of memory systems, particularly in situations at the scale of real-world experiences. His work has revealed important continuities between working memory and long-term memory systems. Dr. Brady.
Thanks for the award. I'm really honored to. Oh, it says I'm muted. Am I muted? Okay.
We can hear you.
We can hear you.
We can hear you.
Okay. So thanks to the APA and the awards committee. I was just thinking how it's tough to be the first early career person. It's tough to follow all those amazing senior colleagues. I hope one day I can accomplish sort of half of what we just heard all of those amazing colleagues accomplishing. naturally, of course, this award, even though I'm early in my career, is really a product of the great work done by all the people in my research lab and all the amazing support and training I've gotten from my mentors over the years. So I'd like to just sort of specifically thank my advisors and mentors. My PhD advisor, Ode Oliva, is amazing in every way and just gave me all sorts of amazing ideas and energy while I was a PhD student. And my postdoc advisor, George Alvarez, also an amazing resource to this day for me. And I'd also like to thank all those people who are mentors to me now that I'm a young professor. I don't think I realized before I was a young professor how much you need mentors when you are a young professor. So specifically John Wixted and John Sorensis in my department here at UC San Diego are amazing mentors, but really the entire department here is just an amazing and supportive place to be junior faculty, and I'm really glad to be here. I'd also like to call specific attention to my entire research lab, both sort of past and present, my postdocs and graduate students, Mark, Maria, Lauren, Chaipot, Jonas, Michael, Anna, Jonathan, Jamal, Isabella, and Hayden are my grad students and postdocs. And of course, they've done lots of the work that, I'm getting some credit here for on behalf of them today. And also my closest collaborators over the past 10 years, which have largely been Talia Conkel and Viola Sturmer, who are some of my great collaborators, fellow professors that I collaborate with. And of course, I really wouldn't be here if it wasn't for my family. So I'd like to really thank my family, both my parents and sister, but also my wife, Adina Schachner, who's another professor in the department here at UCSD and who does all of this with me, helps me figure out how to be a professor, and my daughters, Hannah and Sophia, who are adorable and make everything happier. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Dr. Brady.
Agreed. As a parent of a one-year-old, they make everything happier. That's really nice. All right. Next, the Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contribution to Psychology and Animal Learning is awarded to Dr. Ben Dancer. Dr. Dancer is recognized for enriching our understanding of both proximate and ultimate causes of animal behavior in natural environments, particularly the evolutionary and physiological mechanisms that enable wild animals to cope with environmental change. Dr. Dancer could not be with us today, but please join us in congratulating him on this achievement.
Congratulations, Dr. Dancer.
All right, the Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contribution to Health Psychology is awarded to Dr. Catherine Ehrlich. Dr. Ehrlich's innovative research brings together insights from multiple sub-areas of psychology, including health, developmental, and social, to address questions of great importance for public health and human development. Dr. Ehrlich.
All right, well, thank you so much. I really want to thank the APA for this incredibly prestigious award. I am, really fostering imposter syndrome here for me today. I realize there are a lot of people who are deserving of this recognition and feel very privileged for the award. I'm grateful to my husband and family who have supported and encouraged my career over these last 15 years. Their support was really critical to me at a number of points along the way. I also want to thank Dr. Andy De Los Rios for nominating me for this award. He's been such a cheerleader for me, as well as countless other early career researchers, and he's the sort of faculty member I hope to be someday. Also need to thank my mentors who have been fabulous, across these 15 years, Drs. Jude Cassidy, Greg Miller, Edith Chen, and Emma Adam, all of whom have just demonstrated incredible patience and generosity and have really shaped the trajectory of my career to date. I also want to thank Drs. Jean Brody and Stephen Beach here at UGA, as well as the staff who are part of the Center for Family Research. The support system here has been really incredible and formative for my pre-tenure years, so I'm grateful for their guidance, as well as members of the Clinical and Translational Research Unit who have been key players in letting us get this work off the ground. Of course, I couldn't do any of this work without my graduate students, Sarah and Kelsey, as well as our amazing undergraduate students and full-time lab staff, all of whom I consider our frontline workers and truly the face of our lab. And last but certainly not least, I really want to thank the families who have been participating in our studies, some of whom have been involved in our research for decades. These families really inspire us and motivate us and also challenge us to question our assumptions about how the world works. And it's a privilege to learn from them. And we're really grateful for them opening up their lives to us. So thanks.
Congratulations so much. Congratulations.
All right, the Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contribution to Psychopathology is awarded to Dr. Luke Hyde. Dr. Hyde's programmatic and novel empirical work has changed how we view the development of antisocial behavior and callous unemotional traits. His research also highlights how familial and neighborhood factors may sculpt brain development and increase risk for psychopathology. Dr. Hyde.
Everyone, thank you for being here this afternoon. I'm really grateful to be able to receive this award today. Some of my research heroes are on the Zoom call right now, so I'm grateful to be on it. I'm particularly honored to be given this honor with so many amazing scholars who have won the award in the past, as well as the other amazing early career scholars who are also being awarded. We got to present at APA, and I was just amazed by their work. I also want to recognize the many other early career scholars who are doing amazing and important work who are not awarded and may not have had the same privilege or platform that I've been fortunate to have in my work. I want to thank the awards committee and the APA for this award. And I wouldn't be able to do any of this work without a lot of support from many mentors and colleagues. My PhD mentor, Danny Shaw, was an ideal mentor for me, generous with his time and ideas and supportive at every step. Ahmad Hariri, my second mentor, helped me broaden my work and learn new techniques, as well as gave me a lot of important life advice on long jogs. I'm grateful for mentorship from many others, including Sue Campbell, Steve Manick, S.E. Veding, and Paul Frick. I've also been fortunate for many amazing collaborators, including Chris Monk and Coulter Mitchell at Michigan and Alex Burt at Michigan State. I'm really grateful for the incredible support from University of Michigan and the Michigan Psychology Department with many, many great colleagues. I also want to thank all the students who have worked in my lab who have really done most of this work. I also want to thank the families that participate in our studies and share their lives with us. Finally, I want to thank my family, my mother, Dr. Janet Hyde, who is a much more esteemed psychologist than I, and has not only been a great help with my career, but also an incredibly resilient and supportive mother. And I want to thank my wife, Dr. Kelly Kidwell, who makes much of the work possible. And really the best part of each day for me is the time that we get to spend together. And I'm really grateful for our two children, Grace and Caleb, who put the joy in our life. So thank you all, and I appreciate being here and for the award.
Thank you so much. Congratulations, Dr. Hyde. And thank you and congratulations as well to your mother, Dr. Hyde. Thank you very much.
The Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contributions to Psychology in Cognition and Human Learning is awarded to Dr. Bonnie Nazari. Dr. Nazari's work focuses on the cognitive and neural basis of language production, providing a fresh look at how attention and control modulate language use and demonstrates the applicability of domain-general computational principles of cognition to the activities of speaking, writing, and typing. Dr. Nazari.
Thank you so much. I want to just echo the sentiment that I am so thrilled to be receiving this award in the early stages of my career, while at the same time acknowledging that there are so many other people who are equally, if not more, deserving than me. So I wish to share this award or accept this award on behalf of women in cognitive science, especially immigrant women who face many, many personal and professional challenges to have a career in science. I am an immigrant woman myself. I'm Iranian, and when I first came to the U.S., I could not visit with my family for 8.5 years. I also could not apply for many funding opportunities as a graduate student and a postdoc, and there were a couple of points in my career where I almost lost a career because of visa and political issues, and it was really, really stressful. The reason that I made it and the reason that I am here today is because I've had the support of some incredible people along the way. First and foremost, my parents, who sent their only child to the other side of the world and never complained a word about me not being there. They offered nothing but support, and for that, I'm forever grateful to them. On this side of the world, also many people on top of the list is my graduate advisor, Gary Dell, who's not just an exceptional scientist, but an amazing human being, and I wish that someday I'm half the mentor as he is. The whole Department of Psychology at the University of Illinois, where I got my graduate degree, amazing people who have supported me throughout the years and continue to support me. my postdoc advisor, Sharon Thompson Schill, people at Johns Hopkins University, where I got my first job, especially Brenda Rapp and RG Hillis, who were my first mentors as a faculty. And as Tim pointed out, I can't emphasize how important having a good mentor is in your first years of faculty job. My current colleagues at Carnegie Mellon, who continue to support me, a lot of collaborators throughout the years, and people who have given me opportunities as an editor or a conference speaker or in different other ways. And finally, my amazing students who inspire me every day, and also the populations that we work with, mostly people who have had stroke, who cannot be a better source of inspiration for human resilience and continuing to basically persist in face of challenges. Thank you, APA, and thank you, everyone. And I hope to be able to help people like myself, just like other people have helped me to be here. Thank you.
Congratulations, Dr. Nazari. Very well deserved. Thank you.
Our next Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contributions in the Area of Psychopathology is awarded to Dr. Michael Treadway. Dr. Treadway is recognized for innovative research on decision-making about expending effort and its role in motivational deficits in psychopathology. This work has led to critical insights into the nature of alterations in reward and motivational processes in affective disorders and other forms of pathology. Dr. Treadway.
Thank you so much. It is incredibly humbling to be sharing a virtual stage with this group. I feel sort of bewildered in some ways to be here. I was somewhat late to psychology. I was a bit of a dark horse candidate. I had never taken a psych course in undergrad and sort of found my way through a sort of personal journey with depression to wanting to study depression. And was fortunate enough along the way to have a number of outstanding mentors take a chance on me. Including my first mentor at Vanderbilt, Marita Grant, followed by two additional mentors really shaped my current research program, one of whom is here today, Steve Holland, who really taught me how to think about the role of anhedonia and got me interested in sort of the potential application of behavioral neuroscience to study deficits in motivation as something that would be really important and impactful depression. And David Zold, a just outstanding translational neuroscientist who really taught me the tools to do the studies that I do. I've also been fortunate along the way to have some outstanding mentors at the postdoctoral level and the junior faculty level, like Diego Pizzagalli. And then since starting my lab here at Emory, working very closely with the group led by Andrew Miller, who's really taught me to think about all the ways in which the body impacts the mind rather than just exploring the mind as if it existed in a vacuum and looking at the contributions of the body and inflammation. To the role, the pathophysiology of depression. And finally, I just really want to thank all the patients who have participated in my studies. The nature of this research, which is trying to understand what changes in the body and the brain when people become depressed, it often involves people going through difficult study protocols, imaging, long days, and it's not really a treatment for them. They're providing a service of letting their experience be understood and studied in the hope that it leads to something better for other people and other generations. And I'm always really moved by that. And I certainly hope I produce research that is worthy of their time. And I'm very grateful for this award. Thank you so much.
All right. And the final award for Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contributions to Develop.
Thank you.
Sorry about that, Dr. Shulman.
No, it's all right. I didn't know whether I'd lost connection or he'd lost connection. So I just want to make sure we honor him one way or the other. Congratulations, Dr. Treadway.
Thank you. All right. The final award for Distinguished Scientific Award for Early Career Contributions to Developmental Psychology goes to Dr. David Yeager. Dr. Yeager is recognized for outstanding contributions to understanding adolescent development and enhancing adolescents' well-being. His work, which draws from multiple areas of psychology, demonstrates deep theoretical, methodological, and statistical sophistication. Dr. Yeager.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much. Thanks to the APA for this award. It's a real thrill and a privilege. You know, I guess I wanted to just say that, you know, individual awards are given to individuals, but science is just so collaborative. It's such a team sport. It always has been, and I don't see that changing in the foreseeable future. And so, you know, more than anything, I want to just say thank you for the opportunity to be in the field, to collaborate. I want to thank my my mentors. One mentor, Carol Dweck, who's visiting us courtesy of Google Images. Some of my colleagues at UT Austin in the Population Research Center, Rob Krosno and Chandra Muller, really helped us with helping us to think big and at scale. And, you know, it's really something I wanted to share this award with others. I think another thing that all of us junior scholars have thought about and we said when we got together over the summer is just what a privilege it is to do the work and also how many privileges we've had in order to be where we are. And I think what's on our minds and maybe many of yours is just thinking, how do we think carefully about the next generation of mentoring and training so that future award ceremonies really just are brimming with the kind of diversity that we see in our population and in our clients. And so, you know, I think going forward, I'm going to continue really thinking carefully about what are the training and mentoring pipelines that we can do and create so that we have the kind of diversity in the professoriate that really represents the people that we want to study and understand. Last, I want to just thank my family. You don't want them on this call because the volume would be at 11 for this whole thing. So we'll just settle for a picture. This is, we have four kids and we've really gotten to know each other during the pandemic. I'll just say that. And so again, just thank you all for the award and for your attention and for your inspiration. Thank you very much.
And congratulations to you, Dr. Yeager.
Dr. Yeager, I'm pretty sure you win at Zoom because you are very quick with all of your fun pictures and everything. So thanks for sharing them with us.
There's been a lot of Zoom in the last 9 months.
You've gotten to know Zoom as well, in addition to getting to know your family better. All right. Congratulations again to our science awardees. Now we'll recognize professional contributions in the areas of applied research, independent and institutional practice, and a student award for contributions to professional psychology. I'd like to ask Dr. Shulman to present this award as the recipient was actually her dissertation advisor.
Yes, the award for distinguished professional contributions to applied research recognizes a psychologist whose research has led to important discoveries or developments in the field of applied research. The recipient of this award, Dr. Nancy Betts, is recognized for her contributions to the psychology of women, vocational psychology and career development, and to psychological measurement, including the measurement of personality. Notably, her research studied factors related to women's decisions about career choices, not just whether or not women worked outside the home. It's also my personal special privilege and a very rare occurrence that an APA president gets to honor her dissertation advisor in this way. I want to thank Nancy, Dr. Betts, for launching my career in psychology and for launching the careers of so many others that I know I can speak for. So I want to say with the deepest heartfelt thanks to my colleague, my friend, and my dear friend and mentor, congratulations, Dr. Betts.
Thanks, Sandy. I have to say that as I got to know you as a graduate student at Ohio State, I'm not the least bit surprised that you became president of APA.
No.
Thank you so much to APA for this award. As a girl growing up in the 1960s, I was discouraged both actively and subtly from pursuing my interest in a career in math and the sciences. I gave up on my interest in a career in the hard sciences and went into psychology. I hoped when I got into psychology that I could do work which would enable psychologists to help women both identify and overcome barriers to the achievement of their career aspirations. I was very lucky when I got to the University of Minnesota that my PhD advisor was David J. Weiss. Dave imparted to me his love of psychological measurement. My love of measurement dovetailed really well with my interest in career development. So over the years, my work has led to theoretical and methodological contributions to women's career development in particular, and career development of individuals in general that are now widely used throughout the country, but very widely used internationally as well. I would like to acknowledge several long-term collaborators. Gail Hackett, who is now at Virginia Commonwealth University, was my first major collaborator. Fred Borgen at Iowa State University was extremely important in my work. Louise Fitzgerald, Eleanor Harmon at the University of Illinois, and Bruce Walsh at The Ohio State University. They all figured prominently in my work, in my contributions. I was very lucky. I had supportive and congenial colleagues at Ohio State University throughout my career there. I also had wonderful graduate and undergraduate students who worked with me on my research, and I cannot thank them enough for their contributions. I would like to dedicate my award to my deceased mother, Ellen L. Betts, who was a prominent psychologist in her own right, who died at the age of 91, and to my 100-year-old dad, who is watching today in Dallas, Texas. Again, thanks to APA for this award. I'm honored to receive it. Thank you.
And Nancy, on behalf of APA, myself and partner Peg, and all of your friends and fans, and loving memory of your mother, Dr. Betts. Congratulations, Dr. Betts.
The next award is the APA APAGS Award for a Distinguished Graduate Student in Professional Psychology, awarded to a graduate student who has demonstrated exemplary performance in the practice and application of psychology. The recipient of this award, Dr. Ana Elba-Hadley Gonzalez, brings great motivation and maximizes research opportunities through her careful work, diligent analyses, and dissemination of what she finds. She is passionate about serving culturally diverse children and families, particularly Hispanic, Spanish-speaking immigrant families. Dr. Elba-Hadley Gonzalez could not be with us today, but please join us in congratulating her on this achievement.
Well, then I will offer my heartiest congratulations to Dr. Elba-Hadley Gonzalez and send our very, very best wishes for her tremendous success and accomplishments, and wish her every success in the future. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Shulman. And thank you, Leslie, as I was scrolling through all the names and you got to it before me. So I appreciate you letting us know. So congratulations to Dr. Elba-Hadley. Next, we have the Award for Distinguished Professional Contributions to Institutional Practice. This award recognizes outstanding institutional practitioners in psychology. The recipient of this award, Dr. Barry Hong, champions psychologist roles, collaborates broadly with clinical and research professionals, and mentors psychologists. He is an active clinician and researcher who has been a leader in multiple professional societies and served on the APA Commission on Accreditation. Dr. Hong.
Thank you. Thank you for the APA for honoring me this way and for the Board of Professional Affairs. I accept this award with deep humility because my career really paralleled the growth of psychology in medical schools and university medical centers. And so it really is, as others have said, a team sport. and special thanks to the Association of Psychologists and Academic Health Centers, because those were the people who were my colleagues and supporters. When I received my PhD in the late 1970s from St. Louis University, there were probably about 150 or perhaps closer to 100 psychologists in medical schools throughout the country. That has all changed now in 2020. There are perhaps thousands of psychologists now active in university medical centers taking the roles of clinicians and researchers. To give you an example, at my own university, a former graduate of our neuropsychology program is now the director of MRI services for the Department of Radiology. And to show you how times have changed, clinical psychologists are members of the medical attending staff at Barnes Jewish Hospital. And so all of this has changed during my lifetime. And finally, I need to thank Washington University for being a wonderful place to live out my career. And for those who are interested, it's been my only adult job, and I've never gone anyplace else. And finally, I'd like to thank my wife, who's sitting behind me out of view, Dr. Faith Schofield, who is a retired school psychologist. I'm in phase retirement, but she's not finished helping me. Thank you.
And thank you, Barry. Congratulations, Dr. Hong.
The Award for Distinguished Professional Contributions to Independent Practice recognizes outstanding independent practitioners in psychology. The recipient of this award, Dr. Adam Wiseman, is a healthcare innovator, leader, and visionary with a mission to revolutionize the mental behavioral health field by increasing access to, disseminating, and implementing best practices and evidence-based treatments for underserved communities. Currently, the Wiseman Children's Foundation provides large-scale pro bono COVID-19 relief across the country. Dr. Wiseman.
Thank you so much, Tara. I am truly honored and humbled to accept this Distinguished Contributions to Practice Award. I'm Dr. Adam Wiseman, founding president of the Child and Family Institute and the Wiseman Children's Foundation, a national nonprofit in development dedicated to promoting mental health equity and access to evidence-based psychological treatments for every child and family in need. This week, we hit a terrible COVID milestone, 300,000 lives lost in the United States alone. And also this week, we saw our frontline healthcare workers get their very first vaccinations, offering us some hope for better days ahead. But unfortunately, there is no vaccine for mental illness. Recent CDC study supports what we're seeing clinically, a hidden mental health pandemic, reporting surges in anxiety, depression, substance abuse, and suicidal ideation during COVID, and disproportionately so among younger adults and racial and ethnic minorities. And a new Oxford University study has now directly linked COVID and mental illness, reporting that those with pre-existing mental health conditions were 65% more likely to be diagnosed with COVID, 65%. The study concluded that mental illness should be regarded as an important COVID risk factor. Now, many of us in the field are aware both the federal government and the insurance companies have not adequately prioritized coverage for effective psychological services. In fact, it's been over a decade since Congress first passed the Mental Health Parity and Addiction Equity Act with its promise to make mental health treatments just as easy to access as other medical services. Yet still today, amid a global pandemic, an economic crisis, and spikes in anxiety, depression, and suicide rates, the vast majority of Americans continue to be denied access to high-quality, evidence-based psychological services. Even more devastating is how this is disproportionately true among underserved communities of color. So to address this gap in mental health access and equity, the Wiseman Children's Foundation has launched a comprehensive COVID mental health relief initiative, helping nearly 150 families and raising more than $45,000 to date. And we're also launching an equity and effectiveness scientific council, partnering with internationally renowned treatment developers to study treatment effectiveness and mental health disparities in the communities we serve. Please consider joining our campaign to help change the mental health landscape and access to care in our country at WisemanChildrensFoundation.org. I'd like to say a very quick thank you to APA for this distinguished honor, and to all of my mentors and colleagues over the years, and to my family for your endless love and support. I am truly blessed to love what I do and to have all of you in my life to share it with. Thank you.
And congratulations, Dr. Wiseman, for your passion, your advocacy, and all of your accomplishments. Thank you so much.
Congratulations to Dr. Weissman and the rest of the practice awardees. Next, we recognize the awards for distinguished contributions to psychology in the public interest. These awards recognize persons who have advanced psychology as a science or a profession by a single extraordinary achievement or a lifetime of outstanding contributions in the public interest. Two awards are given, the first to a senior psychologist and the second to a psychologist who has made a significant contribution to the public interest in the early stages of their career. The recipient of the Senior Career Award for Distinguished Contributions to Psychology in the Public Interest is Dr. Perry Halkidis. For three decades, Dr. Halkidis' research has examined the intersection between HIV, HPV, and other sexually transmitted infections, drug abuse, and mental health burden with regard to the biological, behavioral, psychosocial, and structural factors that predispose these and other health disparities in the LGBTQ population. Dr. Halkidis could not be with us today, but please join us in congratulating him on this achievement.
On behalf of the APA, I just want to take this time to congratulate Dr. Perry Halkidis on all of his tremendous contributions that have been so impactful and important to the lives of so many others. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Shulman. All right, the recipient of the Early Career Award for Distinguished Contributions to Psychology in the Public Interest is Dr. Valerie Earnshaw. Dr. Earnshaw is recognized for her innovative research on stigma and health inequities, as well as remarkable national and international contributions to advancing theoretical perspectives for understanding how stigma affects health inequities across the lifespan, particularly in the context of HIV, AIDS, and substance use disorders. Dr. Earnshaw.
Thank you for that kind introduction. I'd like to offer a very heartfelt thank you to the APA as well as the Public Interest Directorate. As a stigma researcher, I can think of no greater honor than to be recognized for work that seeks to solve social problems as well as advance social justice and human welfare. I'm also very grateful to the Committee on Psychology and AIDS for their nomination and support. I have been very lucky to learn from and collaborate with smart and talented psychologists working on issues related to HIV. On a personal note, I'd like to thank my mom, Linda Earnshaw, who took on HIV stigma as a nurse in the 80s and 90s, and my partner, Brian Hand, who has supported and encouraged me every step of the way since undergrad. I'm also extremely grateful to a very long list of mentors, collaborators, colleagues, and students. I feel very proud to be a member of a community of psychologists working hard to promote HIV prevention and treatment, address substance use disorders, eliminate stigma, and achieve health equity. I'm actually quite glad that this is an early career award because I feel that we have a great deal more to accomplish, and I'm looking forward to continuing that work alongside my fellow psychologists who are working hard on behalf of the public interest. So thank you again.
And thank you, Dr. Earnshaw. Your work is so vital right up to the very present. As you know, 2020 has been a year that has just highlighted the significance of health inequities, of stigma, of substance abuse, and your longstanding work that has contributed so much to fighting these issues and creating something positive for the public is so needed and appreciated. So on behalf of APA, we thank you and we congratulate you.
Thanks so much, Dr. Shulman.
The next award to be presented is for distinguished contributions to research and public policy. This award is given to a psychologist who has made a distinguished empirical and/or theoretical contribution to research and public policy, either through a single extraordinary achievement or a lifetime of work. This year, the award goes to Dr. Gary Wells. Over the course of his career, Dr. Wells has worked tirelessly with policymakers, practitioners, and news media to advocate for reforms that prevent wrongful convictions. Dr. Wells.
I'm very happy to receive this award. It does represent for me, you know, a lifetime of work. I would have a lot of people to thank, certainly all my PhD students over the years who are now spread around the country at universities. They were a critical part of all this work. as well as really people in 50 states. I traveled to all 50 states over a 25-year period to affect the kind of change in policy of involving procedures and policies on eyewitness identification, and it was a long trek, but there were a lot of people who helped me along the way. Of course, you know, over 200 publications, but that doesn't mean anything when it comes to affecting policy. You still have to get out there. You have to beat the bush. You have to give a lot of credit to people. You know, a lot of things can get done if you let other people take the credit. And I learned that early on. But there were a number of great people throughout this, starting, I think I would mention among the most important people, former U.S. Attorney General, the late Janet Reno, who gave me a lot of great breaks in terms of coming in to the legal system from academia, from research, from experimental labs, and getting the word out all across the country to law enforcement and to others about how we can improve eyewitness identification evidence to reduce wrongful convictions, which were, you know, pretty rampant and to some extent are still going on. I wish I had my full list of graduate students here. I'm not going to pick out just a few and play favorites. I wasn't prepared for the full list, but they really have been critical, and they're now planted around the country and helping work with law enforcement and doing research that further improves eyewitness identification policies and procedures. So those are my main remarks, I guess, at this point. Thank you.
Well, and congratulations, Dr. Wells, for such outstanding contributions, both to you and to all the collaborators and all the people that have worked on behalf of the people so hard. So congratulations. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Shulman. All right, all the best and congratulations to our public interest awardees. Our final award of the evening, the 2020 Raymond D. Fowler Award, recognizes an APA member who has had a significant and enduring impact on APA as an organization and has shown a clear dedication to advancing APA's mission. This year's recipient is Dr. Linda Forrest, Professor Emerita at the University of Oregon. Emerita, sorry. Dr. Shulman, please present this award.
I'd be personally delighted to do this. Linda's been a long, dear friend and colleague. We recognize Dr. Forrest's dedication to APA's mission to advance psychology for the benefit of society and the improvement of lives, faithfully, ethically, enduringly, and always with unique hope and optimism about its future. Her deep engagement with APA has included many influential leadership roles where she has made outstanding contributions in the areas of training and supervision, ethics, mentoring, diversity, and leadership. In nominating Dr. Forrest for this award, one of our other colleagues, Dr. Ruth Fassinger, wrote, quote, "She has given not just her time and her heart to APA, but also her treasure through her dedicated service to the American Psychological Foundation as well. And she has had an enduring impact on the association and on psychology more broadly through her mentoring and tireless support of her colleagues, her ethics work, her championing of diversity, her infusion of the best aspects of feminism into this organization, her deeply sensitive understanding of organizational process and politics, and her ability to use power productively, and her perseverance on things that matter. I cannot tell you how honored I am to be able to present the Raymond D. Fowler Award for 2020 to my dear friend and colleague, Linda Forrest."
Thank you, Sandy. It's wonderful to receive this award with you reading the citation. I want to thank my very sneaky colleagues who nominated me for this award, Ruth Fassinger, Linda Campbell, Aisha Sitsi, and Barry Chung. I was totally surprised when I got the news, and I was caught completely off guard and blown away. Receiving any APA award is very special. For me, receiving an award for service is the best. My professional and personal life has been much enriched by psychology. Psychology has provided me endless opportunities to be involved in deeply meaningful work with hopes of benefiting society and improving lives. And being part of psychology's public interest efforts championing diversity, equity, and inclusion. Because psychology has enriched my life in wonderful ways, it has only been natural that I would give back to psychology by volunteering and serving APA. Though it hasn't always been easy, because APA takes on big, complex, challenging, and tough issues. Serving on APA boards and committees and working groups over the last 30 years has placed me in some very difficult situations that have required me to stretch and grow as a leader. These demanding, growing leadership responsibilities have been part of why I return again and again to serve APA in new roles and taking on new problems. Most important, though, is that I have developed very meaningful and long-standing friendships while serving on the various APA boards and committees. Some of my dearest friendships have been formed while we've been in the trenches, taking these big, complex, challenging problems. My 2 minutes are up, but before I end, I want to thank my husband, Warren Holmes. Thanks to COVID, Warren has appreciated my being home this year rather than many weekends in DC. Like all of you, this year, all my APA service has been from home on Zoom. I'm grateful and appreciative that Warren gets how important it is for me to be engaged with other psychologists in addressing big societal issues. Receiving this award has been an impetus to reflect on all the many talented psychologists with whom I have had the privilege to work and what we have accomplished together. A heartfelt thanks to my colleagues for giving me these many opportunities to serve APA and for this deeply meaningful recognition. Thank you.
Congratulations, Dr. Forrest. So well deserved. This certainly has been a really wonderful occasion to recognize psychology's best and brightest and most accomplished. Again, I would like to offer my personal congratulations to the recipients of the APA Awards and offer congratulations on behalf of all members of the American Psychological Association. Thank you for sharing your achievements and enduring efforts with us. Before I close the ceremony, there are some important people that I need to thank here, and that's the APA staff. I can tell you as APA president this year, I have gotten to see what an incredible treasure our staff is at APA and how much they have played a role in the success of everything that we have done well this year. And so from the bottom of my heart, I just want to thank the staff. You've been terrific and you deserve an award all by yourselves. And then, of course, I would like to thank you for organizing, coordinating this program, and also thanking our MC, Tara Davis. And I want to thank all of the friends, the loved ones, and the family for being a very special part of what is a special occasion that we have created under a COVID environment to say thank you to some of our most outstanding contributors, friends, and colleagues. So I thank you all for coming. I thank you all for being who you are, and I wish you every health and success in the future. So take care, everybody, and please be safe. Thank you so much.